Welcome back to Spiller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to work with quadratic equations, and we know from previous videos that a quadratic equation is nothing more than a polynomial of degree 2. So let's go ahead and begin. The height of an arrow can be modeled by this function, and we see this function is a quadratic because its highest exponent is 2, where the value of x is the arrow's horizontal distance in feet. So let's begin with part A. We need to find the horizontal distance the arrow travels before it hits the ground. Before we start the problem, let's take a look at a quick little sketch. Let's say this here is our xy coordinate, and we're just going to just freehand how this arrow is traveling. It's going to travel in a position something like this, which we know that is just a basic parabola. All right, when that arrow is shot, we have the x-axis, which is here. And this x-axis is going to be the horizontal distance that this particular arrow travels. What they're asking in this question is, how far does that arrow travel before it hits the ground? We know that when the arrow hits the ground, its vertical height has to be 0. So in this example, we're going to set f of x or the value of y to 0. So let's begin. We're going to begin with our polynomial. I'm just doing a basic rewrite here. And I'm setting that equal to 0, because we know that f of x is equal to y. And in this case, that vertical distance, or that vertical height, we want to set equal to 0. Next, for us to find the roots or the places where this parabola touches the x-axis, in this case, we have to use the quadratic equation. Quadratic equation should be memorized, but in some testing areas, or depending on what's going on, your teacher or instructor, they may give you a formula sheet. Alright, well, the quadratic equation is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, where all of that is divided by the expression 2a. In this particular example, we need to grab the coefficients for each one of our terms. The coefficient for our x squared term corresponds to a, and that's negative 5/1000. The coefficient for the x term is 2, and our constant here is 5. What we need to do at this point is to substitute those values into our quadratic equation. All right, so let's start with the value of b, which we said was 2, but the formula says that we need to have a negative in front. 2 squared is 4, and then we're going to multiply 4 times the negative 5/1000 times c, which is 5. And then all of that will be divided by 2 times negative 5/1000. As we continue to simplify, we end up with negative 2 plus or minus 4 plus 1/10. When you multiply negative 4 times negative 5/1000 times 5, you end up with a positive 1/10. And then all that needs to be divided by our denominator. Once I simplify or resolve this denominator, I end up with a negative 100. All right. And once I pull up my calculator and continue to resolve this, I'm going to end up with two solutions. One solution is negative 2 48/100, and the other solution is 402 48/100. Since we're talking about the distance traveled of a real object, we know that distance traveled is not going to be negative, so we can disregard that. So we come to the conclusion that when that arrow was shot, it travels a horizontal distance, or an x distance, of 402 48/100 feet. Now, depending on the circumstance, either you need to do a check, or if your teacher allows you to use calculators, let's take a look at the calculator and see how we can do this using one of the Texas Instruments calculators. All right, then let's begin. Okay, let's pull up the calculator and check this one. First, let's go to window. We know that we're going to have an x value of 400, or we're expecting an x value of 402 feet and 4800. So let's set the maximum value, let's say, to 450. I'm not quite sure how high the arrow travels at this moment, so let's set the maximum height to 300. Right, now let's go back to, let's go to y equals, and now let's enter in this particular function here. So it was negative 5,000 x squared plus 2x plus 5. So that's entered, and now let's go ahead and graph this particular function. Now, as we suspect, we see that it is graphing in the shape of a parabola, again, which is a quadratic equation. All right, we want to do now second, and then press the trace button so we can get to these calculation functions, or these calc functions. The function that we want to get to is number 2, which would be 0. We want to calculate the 0, which just means tell us where this particular function crosses the x-axis. We're not interested in this crossing position here because that's where the arrow is shot from. We're interested in the x value over here. So let's find our left bound, and we see that the calculator is asking for that here. We want to be to the left of this position where the parabola crosses the x-axis. Let's get close to it because that allows the calculation of the calculator to happen at a faster rate. All right, that's our left bound, so let's go ahead and press enter. Now notice the calculator wants the right bound. Let's move to the right of that. If our little, we'll call a little spider, if that moves off the screen, we know we're to the right. So there we are to the right. Let's press enter again. It wants us to enter a guess. We don't want to enter a guess. We'll let the calculator just begin its calculations between these two values here. And we see that the calculator comes up with a value of 402 and 48 hundredths, just like we calculated by hand. So we did a good job there. Let's scroll up and let's take a look at part B of this particular question. All right, for part B, we need to find the maximum height of the arrow. Well, to find the maximum height, we need to find this y value to tell us what's going on up here. First, let's calculate it by hand, and then we'll go back and check our work using the calculator. So we begin by knowing that x will be is found by the expression negative b over 2a, where b and a are the same values that we used earlier for the quadratic equation. And we know that to find the value of y, y would be taking the function and inputting that x value, in which we're using the expression negative b over 2a. Let's begin by doing our substitutions. We said earlier that the value of b would be 2. Again, we use the negative because that's in our expression. And we're going to multiply that by 2 times negative 5,000ths. Once we do that, we see that x comes out to a value of 200. And now we're going to take this value of 200 and put that back into our original function. So f of 200 will be equal to negative 5,000ths times 200 squared plus 2 times 200 plus 5. And again, all I did here was go back to this original equation that we had, and I input values of 200 for each place where I see x. And once I resolve that, that's going to give me the height or the y value for the arrow. And in this case, that's going to come out to 205 feet. Now, let's go to the calculator and let's verify that our maximum, that the maximum height of this arrow is 205 feet. Let's begin by pressing second and then calc again. And this time we want to go down to 4, which would be the maximum value or the maximum. Again, the calculator is asking for the left bound. So let's move over as far left, not as far left as possible, but we want to move anywhere past what I would consider the vertex or the maximum value, which I would guess to be somewhere in this region. So I want to move the arrow somewhere around here, or I'm sorry, the little pointer on the function somewhere over there. Go a little bit more. All right, so that's good enough for the left bound. Press enter, and then let's move this little spider to the right-hand side. past what I would consider to be the maximum. And then let's go down here and press enter again. A little too aggressive there with that right arrow. Now it's again, calculator wants a guess. Let's press enter. And we see that the Y value does come out to be 205 feet, just like we calculated by hand. So this here was a quick tutorial on calculating the distance something travels and also the height using the quadratic equation and other relationships that we know when dealing with parabolas or quadratic equations. Thank you again for watching this video. Please friend us on Facebook, like our or thumbs up or plus one our YouTube channel, and continue to look out for more videos from us here at Spell Tutorial Services. Thank you again for watching.